What's going on, y'all? Riley here. Today we're going to be taking a look and comparing the original Shonen Jump Viz Media printing of Shaman King to the new Kodansha Omnibus Edition. So stay tuned. So I think it was last summer that the news broke from Kodansha that they were going to be publishing this new printing of the classic Shonen series, modern classic, Shaman King from Hiroyuki Takei. Now, this series was one that was not super popular in the States, but was popular enough, and it had enough attention in the States, and it was a little more popular in Japan, definitely. But it was one that was in the monthly Shonen Jump magazine back when it was coming out. It was one of the inaugural titles in that magazine alongside, like, Dragon Ball Z and Yu Yu Hakusho, Yu-Gi-Oh, and then titles that were not in the US, like Shaman King, before this, like Naruto and One Piece. So I had been reading it since back in about 2003, and I think in 2007 was when I finished the series, and it wasn't until a few years ago that I actually decided I wanted to own the whole series, and so I bought all of the original Shonen Jump volumes, and this was when they were actually still really easy to find for super cheap prices. Not too long after that, they went out of print, and it started to get really hard for people to find these volumes, and while I was lucky because I did pick it up right in time to add it to my collection, a lot of people were not so lucky and were looking for these books, and it became something that was really sought after. So whenever Kodansha came out and said that they were going to be doing this new printing, it was a big deal. A lot of people were super excited. A lot of people who never were able to read it before will get a chance to read it now for the first time. And likewise, a lot of people who maybe had read it before but never were able to add it to their collection are now able to do that as well. So I was really excited, and I made a video where I kind of explained my feelings on the series, just basic ideas of, you know, whether I like the series or not, and whether it might be worth it to go ahead and buy those new Kodansha books. And in there I mentioned that we'll have to do a follow-up to that video by actually taking a look and comparing the two when this one had come out. So obviously this one has come out recently and I have it in hand now, so let's go ahead and take a look and compare the two. If you want some description of the series, that's not what's in here, go check out the other video I'll link down below. I talk about how I feel about the series, kind of a description about what it's about, and I put up some pictures and stuff so you get an idea what the artwork looks like and kind of what Takei was going for here. But today, all we're doing is comparing the old printing to the new printing so anyone can get an idea basically of whether or not they want to if they have the old printing like I do, if they want to hang on to it, if they don't have the old printing, if they might want to buy the new ones as they come out or seek out the old one. This is just kind of to help people with that and to give people an idea of what Kodansha did to differentiate this new printing of theirs from the old Viz Media Shonen Jump printing. So let's go ahead and jump into it. I'm gonna switch the view to kind of a POV first person so you guys can have a great look at what these actually look like. So let's go. All right, so let's get up close and personal with these books. Obviously, I have the new printing for Kodansha here, and these are the first three volumes of Viz Media's printing under the Shonen Jump label. I wanted to compare to these so that we could see exactly what comparison there is in size. And as you can see, there's very little difference between the size as far as thickness between the three volumes versus the one new volume. It's a little bit thinner, but I'm gonna put that up to the fact that there's more of these thick covers on this side, since it's got three front and back covers compared to the one front and back cover here. Now we can compare this to the thickness of one of Viz Media's 3-in-1 books, and this is the 3-in-1 of Yu-Gi-Oh! And you can see that even though there's about the same amount of pages between these two volumes, that Yu-Gi-Oh! Is significantly thinner. And this was one of the topics that a lot of people were curious about when it came to the new Kodansha printing, is whether they were going to use the thinner paper or whether they were going to use a thicker paper. And it goes to show that it's pretty much the same thickness of paper that you get from the original volumes that Viz printed. Now, as far as the front cover goes, we've known for a little while that the front cover was going to have new artwork and that we also have the new logo for Shaman King. This is basically what's being used now for the franchise as we get the new anime and all that stuff. So the covers do look a little bit different, and of course the design on the cover of the Shonen Jump version is basically typical for what Shonen Jump used. They would have that little swoop, the crescent on there with the number. They usually choose a motif with the color matching whatever the logo looked like. Meanwhile, in the other one from Kodansha, it's got just the volumes 1, 2, 3, as well as Hiroyuki Takei's name on there. So that's a good comparison. It does still have the, it's the same basic image on both of these, just, you know, an updated style from Takei on the Kodansha one. And then it does have still the same black background. Now we can take a look at the spines as well. And to me, the spines are going to be probably the most important. And you can see I have a little bit of damage on there, just a little bit of the green rubbed off in transit, either to me or to the store or whatever happened. But the spine to me is more important than the front or the back, because the spine is what you're going to see on your shelf. So that's what you're going to see every day. Now, the classic Shonen Jump one was pretty standard for what they were producing as far as how their volumes looked. You can see that there's not a lot of interesting stuff going on with the spine. This did stand out though, because all of the other titles, especially those early Shonen Jump ones that were published in the US, had white spines. The vast majority of them had white spines, but Shaman King was different because that one had a black spine. I think that Yu-Gi-Oh! Also, the first part may have had black, or at least the first volume, I don't know for sure. Someone will correct me. But now you have a lot of different designs on the spines of all of Shonen Jump's books. And of course, they've changed their logo as well significantly since the old one, the original one. And the Viz Media logo is also different. You can see that this is one of the old original printings of this book. The logo or the title on the spine here is not in any sort of specific and interesting font. That's another thing that I wanted to point out, because most Shonen Jump manga that were being published at the time did not have an interesting font style on the spine. They just had a standard printed title there. And then as the publisher continued to put out more books, they would do a little bit more to give kind of a title design, I guess, to the series. And I'll grab a book to kind of show what I mean. So I grabbed a few others just to kind of show what I mean. You can see Shaman King is very plain. Out of the ones that I've picked out, Naruto has the best design as far as the font on the spine goes, because it does match the font more or less of what's on the cover for the title. But when you look at like One Piece, that is very far from what the title looks like on the front. And the same goes for Hikaru no Go, having a very different design for the actual title logo than what's on the spine. Now, if we look at something that was just a little bit newer, you started seeing little variation looking at Beat the Vandal Buster Volume 1 in how that title was. That more represents what was on the cover. But when you look at more recent titles, and I chose a couple of really good ones, let's look at Haikyuu and Black Clover. They have a lot more design elements to the title on the spine that make it match the way that the title is on the cover of the books. So just kind of pointing that out to say that the original Shaman King books really didn't have much interesting going on as far as the title goes, but on the new one, and finally getting around to the point like a minute and a half later, has that new logo design on the cover as well as being on the spine. As well as on the spine, I'm going to take all of these extra books away now. It looks like we're going to have a character appear on the spine. If I was to guess, and we won't know until we get the second volume, but if I was to guess, we're probably going to have every volume feature a different character on the spine. And given that there's only going to be like 11 volumes or whatever the total was, there's plenty of characters they can choose from, so we'll get to see which 11 characters they get to choose. And maybe there will be two characters on the spines. It also kind of appears that there might be... right there, it looks like it might have a continuing image on the spines. It looks like there might be a character who's going to continue on from here. And so we'll have one big image of kind of the main cast of characters along the spines. And that's going to look really nice. I think that there's a little bit too much empty space up here on the white for me. But other than that, I think it's going to look really nice on the shelf. I'm guessing because this has the green motif here, and that's why we have the green motif there. I think that the future volumes, I've already noticed that the logo has a different color motif, like red or whatever, in future volumes. So we should see the color on the spine change as well as that character. So as this goes forward, I think it's going to be really nice looking on the shelf. And let's look at the back covers as well.
So back covers are pretty different between the two. Obviously, we have all the standard stuff for a Kodansha book, and this has all the standard stuff that an older Viz Media Shonen Jump title had. And they both give the descriptions of the titles along with a little bit of artwork. So we have on here gives a nice description as well as saying the best-selling classic returns in a new omnibus edition. And then we have on this side, Viz, since this had just come out and there was the anime had just recently hit as well around the same time that the physical volumes were being collected. You just have the little tagline of the original manga version of the incredible TV series, including stories not seen in the anime. So obviously some variation on what the backs look like of these volumes. But I know that what everyone's really wanting to see is probably going to be the interiors, comparing the artwork and even the translation between the two books. Now I'm going to show a little bit of the stuff. I'm not going to show every single difference because this would be an hours long video and I don't want to take up your time like that. So we're just going to highlight a few of the different things so you can get an idea of how the difference is going to be in the translation for the new version when compared to the old version. So right from the start, you can see that the title pages are stylized differently. Obviously the left is the new one still. And then we can also see any differences in the titles of the chapters. So in this first volume worth of chapters, the only difference here is that Soul Boxing chapter 4 has an exclamation point added at the end of the new printing. The other differences you can spot are that in the original Viz, they called each chapter a reincarnation. And as well, the volume one title was A Shaman in Tokyo. Whereas in the Kodansha version, they just call them chapters. And the subtitle of volume one is The Boy Who Dances with Ghosts. Now, looking just at that first page of artwork, we can see that the Kodansha version is blown up just a little bit. And they've changed the way that the font looks slightly by making it larger and not using the exact same font that's in the Viz Media version. The translation here is pretty much the same. The biggest difference being that the image is blown up and retouched a little bit. You can see that on there, that the black and whites look a little bit different between the two. And again, that the font is actually enlarged on the Kodansha version. Now let's look at some of the interiors. This is the Viz Media version. So notice a couple things. We'll notice the sound effects are translated. So they've removed the kanji sound effects and replaced them with English sound effects. And the other thing I'm going to point out is this double speech bubble right there. The way that the words are just right in the middle there, they're not adjusted to make sense for there to be a speech bubble that looks like that, where there's a smaller one here, which is not a big deal. And this was definitely a lot more common in these earlier volumes. And you can see also that the letters, the kerning on the letters gets a little too close to the wall of the speech bubble on here. And these are things that are not going to completely ruin the experience of reading the book. However, I like to say just, you know, if I was turning that in for a project, you'd probably get, you know, a point off for that kind of stuff. Because it's just something that's small and a little bit lazy. But if we look at the new version, there are some differences there. So first, sound effects. They keep the kanji sound effects and add a smaller English translation next to them. So that is keeping the artwork more similar to what the original was, because you're not removing the lettering of those sound effects. Now, this, the other thing I mentioned here, the kerning on the letters, it's shrunk down. The text is shrunk down enough that it doesn't get too close to the side of those speech bubbles. And then this one here, they separate the statement. The translation is still pretty much the same, but I'll, ellipsis, cut through the cemetery. So that now it makes sense for there to be these two parts, this kind of growth off of the speech bubble. So it doesn't look weird having just this one statement in the middle of a, you know, double speech bubble like that. The artwork is also slightly adjusted here. Some of it is a little bit brighter in comparison, and they've blown up some of the text a little bit in other places. So there's a lot of little differences that you can spot between the two. And just to give kind of a look of both next to each other, you can see a couple differences here. The left side being the Kodansha print, the blacks are a lot more sharp, creating more contrast between the dark and light colors. You can really see a difference in the building in the background. On the Viz Media printing, it's kind of all fading together, whereas on the Kodansha printing, that building has different highlights, so you can tell there's more detail in there. As well, the text on the bottom there is outlined so that that black does not just blend into the gray of the background. And then you see the grave that Yo is sitting on is not translated in the old version, but it is translated here. And they even adjust the weird that Manta says here and have the ellipsis actually follow directly after the word on the Kodansha version. All right, now let's look at the title page for the volume twos in each book. And I know the camera angle is not great, but I'm trying to use my hands here to hold down the books. But you can see one thing that's different is that they did keep the old logo from this title page. Whereas in the first volume, it was the English logo that's on the cover. Now in this one, the titles of each volume do change. Volume 2 of the original printing was Kung Fu Master, whereas the second volume in the new Kodansha Omnibus is A Shaman's Ambition. The chapter titles, we see, it looks like most of them are the same. There's no hyphen in Kung Fu on the Kodansha edition, but everything else is the same. All the other chapter titles are the same, of course, aside from being called chapters in Kodansha and reincarnations on the Viz version. And then another quick look, and again, I know the angle's not great because I'm using my hands to hold the book, but you can see the background here compared to the Viz version. They actually have a stylized sky behind the hospital there. The font that's used here for the Funbari General Hospital is different than the one in the Viz version. As well, the way that Yo's name is written here is different, and here they have it on two separate lines, whereas here it's all on one line and it's made a little bit darker, whereas this one is, the sign is lighter, but the background is the darker one. So just some minor adjustments to the artwork, and then again, some minor adjustments down here you can see to the structure of the way that the translation is presented. It's still the exact same sentence, except they add kun at the end of Yo here, so he still hasn't regained consciousness. Come on, Yo, on the old version, the new one, he still hasn't regained consciousness. Come on, Yo-kun. So there's a slight difference on there as well. And here's another small thing to pay attention to, just on the chapter 9 title pages here. And ignore any yellowing you see on this one. This I bought, I mentioned early in the video, secondhand. From a used bookstore, so this was not from me leaving in the light. I block all the light to come in from my library while I'm not filming. But you can see that they use a different font here, which looks pretty good. I don't have any issue with the font that's used in there. They use a more plain font, but the part that I like better on this new one is that they actually move the title up to the top where I feel like it should be, because having it on the bottom, you can see they even stretch the artwork here. They leave more art underneath these pillars, and it's not anything particular, but up here on this side, it's just a big empty space, and they use that empty space for the title here. So that just, to me, it's more aesthetically pleasing to have it look like that. Now let's look at the volume threes. Once again, you can see that they've used the same logo. They have Shaman King against Tokugawa's head. And that's the same on the new edition too. I know you can't see it that well right there, but it is the same. The title is different. Volume 3, Lizard Man, and the new one is The Harbinger Stars. So definitely very different as far as the title goes on there. And then this one, we actually feature a different translation for one of the chapter titles, where in, well, one thing, they changed the way Tokugawa's name is spelled to add the H at the end on the new translation. So that we see in Tokugawa's blue Blues, and then the integral Tokugero. And then in chapter 25, the title from Viz was The Dragon's Gratitude, whereas they leave it as Ryu's Gratitude in the new version. So there are some translation differences between the two. And again, I know you can't really tell that well by the way that I'm holding it, but at the best angle that I could. So there are some differences here, and you can see, again, just looking at the actual artwork, big difference being the translation of the sound effects being left alone. And that's something that's going to be big and different. And again, you see another background here that's got actually colored in sky compared to the white sky on the other side. Even the font that's used on the Kodansha version, where it says the same thing. It says the happy place, the final utopia on both sides, but it has more of that standard Comic Sans type font on the Viz version, while on the Kodansha version, it's a little bit different. And that's, I guess, the same font that they've been using, but there's just a little difference there in the way that the font looks. But that big change being all the way through this translation, that the sound effects are not translated. So that's basically what I was wanting to show, was those types of basic things. So that's what you can expect from the two different versions. The new one is going to have, the artwork is edited to where the there's going to be more shading, there's going to be more contrast, I think is the biggest issue that they're kind of fixing, is any issue with contrast between the darks and the lights. The font style that they use has been changed, and some of the translations of the names are changed, and then the way that they format the text for all of the dialogue and stuff like that is changed just a little bit to make it a little more pleasing when you read it, so it's not so close to, like I showed off earlier, text not getting too close to the wall of the bubbles. They leave margins, which is something that's important for making something that's pleasing to the eye, because you want to, when writing anything, you want to use a font and use kerning with that font, and use anything else with that font that is going to help make that more pleasing to the eye to read for whoever's reading it, because you don't want someone to be reading and just get tired. You want that to flow very easily. And adjusting that, even though it seems like something small, adjusting that on Kodansha's side, adjusting the margins, adjusting the kerning, adjusting the way that the font looks, and adjusting the way that every dialogue bubble is fit, every piece of dialogue is fit to the bubble that it fits in, that is going to do a lot as far as the production of this new translation goes. So I hope I've given a good look at all the changes so that you guys kind of get an idea of how this new edition is going to look, how it's going to differ from the original one. And now hopefully you can make a decision for yourself of whether you want to try and track down the original printings, or if you're going to be happy with going with the new printing from Kodansha.
So that's it for the look at the new printing in comparison to the old one. I think I covered everything, obviously not every single difference, but I covered enough to give you guys an idea of what the new printing looks like in comparison. I know there's probably a few like bigger translation differences as far as the way that things were translated between the two versions, but I didn't go through the entire book to seek out every single translation in comparison with the original printing, because I honestly, if I'm being real, I just don't have the time to sit there and look back and forth between both titles. But if there's anything else, any additional information that you would want to know about the differences between these books, please let me know. I want to be able to help people to decide for themselves whether they want to either keep or seek out the original Viz Shonen Jump printing, or if they want to go with the new Kodansha printing. For me, I really like what they've done here. I'll say the biggest negative is just in how big the book is as far as the thickness. And the only reason that's a negative is because if you're not careful, you can definitely crease the spine on these thicker volumes. So I would just say read carefully whenever you get this and are reading through this book so that you don't accidentally crease or damage your spine. Other than that, I think everything they've done to update the translation on this book and updating the contrast in the artwork and the blacks and whites and grays and stuff is fantastic. I think that they've done a really good job in bringing this back, and I'm just so happy that now Shaman King is around again, and it's going to be available in a really, honestly, cheap version. It's $20 for like 600 pages of material, as compared to, well, originally these were $8 each, but if they were published now, they'd be $10 each. So it would be originally, what, $24 worth of material. So you're saving $4, but you'd be saving a whole $10 off the cover price between the two if this was printed more recently. But I like it. I like it personally. I'm not 100% sure if I want to trade out the originals for the new ones because I really like my original ones. But I am very tempted to buy all these because it really, really looks great. I love the presentation of the Kodansha version of these books. I do wish that they were oversized. I wish that the trim size of this was a little bit larger, which would make up a little bit for the thickness. It would make it not seem as thick if it was a little bit taller and wider, but it is what it is. So what do you guys think? A, was there anything more that you wanted me to cover as far as the differences? I can, you know, let you know in the comments down below. Just let me know what differences you're looking for me to point out. And I'll try and do my best to kind of point them out to you and stuff like that. And B, what are you gonna do? If you already have these printings like I do you plan on picking these up? Do you think of this as an upgrade or do you think of this as a downgrade? And if you don't have the original English printings, which one would you rather go with? Are you gonna get the new ones or are you gonna get the old ones? Let me know. I'm really curious about what you guys have to say because I did this for you guys to have all the information that you need to make the best educated decision as far as your purchase that you could make. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that it was entertaining, and of course I hope that it was informative for everyone that needed this information. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, go ahead and click the subscribe button down below and hit that bell so you're notified of all the manga and comic related content that I publish every week. And if you're already subscribed, then thank you so much for coming back and spending time with me. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace out.